Well, to be honest, we kind of knew this day was coming.
Hey everyone, this is Kevin T. Rodriguez, film critic of iCritic.net, and yep, still shareholder of Helios and Matheson. Something tells me I went down with the ship, just like I said I would. Now, for those of you who've been going to the MoviePass website for a while, you've seen this MoviePass service disruption notice, where they said, "Dear MoviePass subscribers, over the past several months, MoviePass worked hard to relaunch its groundbreaking subscription service and recapitalize the company. While we were able to relaunch the service for some of our subscribers with an improved technology platform, our efforts to recapitalize the company have not been successful to date. As a result, it pains us to inform you that effective at 8 a.m. Eastern on September 14th, 2019, we must interrupt service for all current MoviePass subscribers. MoviePass will be providing subscribers with appropriate refunds for their period of service already paid for. Subscribers will not need to request a refund or contact MoviePass customer service to receive a refund." We'll see if that's actually true, by the way. Subscribers will not be charged during the service interruption. At this point, we are unable to predict if or when the MoviePass service will continue. We still deeply believe in the need for the MoviePass service in the marketplace. To maintain affordable access to theaters and provide movie lovers with choices of where to go to the movies. Except, of course, that's now being provided by the theaters themselves. You know, we've got the AMC Stubs A-List, we've got the Regal Unlimited. To a certain extent, we have the Cinemark Movie Club. So, I mean, MoviePass was still useful for independent theaters. Heck, I did use my MoviePass one more time for Super Size Me 2 for a Lemley theater. Was it Lemley? I forget which one it was. Well, anyway, it was in Beverly Hills. So I got to use MoviePass one more time last weekend for Super Size Me 2. But for the most part, yeah, this service is being provided for the theaters themselves. In August 2017, MoviePass began a transformation of the movie-going industry by introducing its low monthly price subscription service. Since then, others in the industry have followed our lead. Yep, which is why you might not be needed anymore. Now, as a result of this transformation, movie lovers throughout the United States have the ability to see movies in theaters using subscription services at prices they can actually afford, albeit with limited choices of theaters using those services. You see, this is their pitch to say we're still relevant. In the course of this industry transformation, MoviePass has experienced setbacks and challenges that are well known. Nevertheless, MoviePass remained committed to leading and competing in an industry that is resistant to outside competition and change. We believe that fostering competition and change in the movie-going industry is critical to the satisfaction of the movie-going public and filmmakers alike. We thank you for your loyalty to MoviePass and sharing our vision for the industry. Although we do not currently know what the future holds for MoviePass service, we hope to find a path that will enable us to continue the service in the future. Sincerely, Mitch Lowe. And for some reason, they are still taking your emails if you want to be, I don't know, notified of whatever they want to do. But here's the thing. Financial Times has pretty much reported that the lights are being turned off and that on Friday, I'm sorry, not Friday, on Saturday, they will explore strategic alternatives, including a possible sale of the group in its entirety. So this is probably more or less the end of everything. So here's the thing. This is not surprising at all. MoviePass was losing way too much money. They lost too much money. They had too much competition near the end there. And honestly, there's not a lot of people who want a MoviePass anymore. Not when there's like the Regal or the A-List. They find out, okay, what theater is next to me, and they're gonna go get that service. So here's the thing. I think it's time to take a ceremonial. This is my wallet, or at least this is the thing that my mother-in-law got me to hold my credit cards and everything. I have maintained my MoviePass card all this time. It's a ceremonial, getting rid of it. Bye-bye, MoviePass. Well, anyway, even though I no longer need. Well, even though I'm no longer going to have MoviePass, you know, thank you, MoviePass, still. I know you had a lot of headaches. I know that there were a lot of problems. Heck, I have been at the end of some of your scams, so to speak. But you know what? I saved thousands of dollars in movies. And you brought a lot of people back to the movies. And because of you did convince Regal and AMC and Cinemark to start their own subscription services and Alamo Drafthouse, you know, all these companies. So I think ultimately your being here was a good thing. You disrupted the industry. You might not be reaping the benefits of it, which is probably the saddest thing. Who knows? Maybe Infinity will be able to pick up where you left off. I don't know. With the closure of Cinemia, I'm suspecting that all the subscription services are going to be for movie theaters right now, not for third-party vendors. But who knows what the future holds. But anyway, this is more than likely the last MoviePass video I will ever make on this channel. For all the subscribers who join me for MoviePass videos, thank you for joining me on this journey. Hopefully you will continue to stick around for future videos as we talk about other things and the movie industry in general. And as always, flame responsibly. Have a good one.